Hey guys and gals, so today we're talking about iron regulation and how crucial it is for athletes, especially endurance athletes, and even more specifically, female endurance athletes. So today I'm gonna give you seven reasons or discussions why every endurance athlete wants to get the iron and the ferritin level checked. I think at the end, I'll give you the actual labs I would suggest, but each of us is gonna think, you know what? I think I'm gonna go out, get my ferritin levels checked, make sure I'm good to go here. All right, so the first thing you wanna consider is that hemoglobin is a protein that requires iron to transport oxygen from our lungs to every tissue in the body. It requires iron. Also, another protein called myoglobin requires iron to transport oxygen within muscle cells. And without sufficient iron available, oxygen carrying capacity is decreased. And that leaves endurance, both systemically and also inside the muscle cell, leaves endurance and overall aerobic capacity hampered. If you're an endurance athlete, you really don't want that happening. So that leads to muscle fatigue setting in earlier and more often, and recovery of that worked muscle tissue, it's now slowed, as the ability to release oxygen and store oxygen in a muscle tissue is compromised. All right, sounds like no fun. Number two, iron is required for the final steps of ATP production. That is, ATP is the energy currents of every cell in our body. You know, that occurs along the electron transport chain. So this is why there's not only a series of, sense of stamina loss, but also a feeling of just general weakness when iron is deficient. Because tissues, muscle tissues, heart tissues, you know, they cannot create sufficient ATP to compensate for the amount of energy being extracted, being asked to be generated by their being. There's just not enough iron around. All right, so number three, as iron deficiency progresses, it can lead to anemia. You know, as the bone marrow cannot create enough hemoglobin anymore. We talked about it at the beginning there. For the body's demands. And this results in, you know, what you commonly hear about as far as fatigue, early fatigue, decreased endurance, and just an overall compromised athletic performance. All right, number four. So intense exercise or long duration exercise, I think most of us understand that it's already, you know, really taxing on the immune system. Person runs a marathon, next thing you know, they're sick the next day. Or they overtrain, sick for weeks at a time. The deal is sufficient iron is paramount for optimal functioning of the immune system. This is overlooked all the time. But you gotta have iron for the immune system. And when iron levels are low and running continues and high intensity, you know, exercising continues, the potential for getting sick increases. And not only that, but you know, optimal iron levels are responsible and necessary for a robust, balanced immune response. So you might get sick all the time if you don't have enough, or you might get sick and like just keep staying sick. And you feel like, man, I just don't recover from my workouts. So we got to check it. If we want to stay consistent, if we want to be able to show up fully for their training, for our training, got to make sure iron levels are good. Number five, training itself can lead to physiological adaptations. We sure hope it does. That promote increased blood flow. So adaptation is why we train. And you know, to continue to see gains in training and improved in performance, it's vital to make sure that iron levels are sufficient to meet those demands of adaptation. Otherwise, we're gonna be hampered. All right, number six, the more training one does, the more microtrauma they're going to experience throughout their body. And the greater the demand for efficiency in recovery becomes. The more you train, the more you need recovery to be on point. And so iron is necessary. It is a necessary component of tissue repair. From literally your hairs on your head to your muscles, to your heart tissue, keeping levels of iron optimal, it reduces the risk of overtraining syndrome and chronic just nagging injuries. And finally, number seven. So often overlooked, in the whole health of the endurance athlete is the nervous system. And when it comes to high level training and generally just pushing our body to try to create that adaptation, you know, to get to that next level, beyond our muscles, optimal iron levels are crucial to maintain well-being. in you know, poor executive function, lack of attention to detail, memory, recall issues. Those are all associated with low iron levels. And if you know you're wanting to just show up as your best self each training session, each event, you know how valuable it is to have your motivation, your drive, your decision making, and your focus just dialed in. So remember, when you're checking iron levels, I got all my seven out. Hope you guys take full advantage of this for information. When you're checking iron levels, at a minimum, get your CBC, your ferritin, your serum iron, your iron saturation, your ceruloplasmin, and your total iron binding capacity checked. Those should be your bare minimum when it comes to getting iron levels checked and seeing where you're at. All right, so if you have any questions, I'm Dr. Matt. Feel free to email us, info@drwholeness.com. That's W-H-wholeness, drwholeness.com, or check out www.optimizeiron.com, because we need optimized iron if we're going to thrive when it comes to our endurance and building greater and greater exercise capacity. All right, hope this is helpful. Talk to you guys later.